Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're learning about how to find the midpoint of what's called a line segment. Just to get started, I better talk to you about what a line segment actually is and a tiny bit of notation. So here's a key word. Now, what's a line segment? A line segment is a straight line that starts at a certain point and finishes at another certain point. So let's say a point A in space. That's where the line starts and it finishes at point B. Whereas this here is supposed to represent a line. And by a line, I mean, yes, it's a straight line, like a line segment, but it doesn't have a start and a finish point. It goes on infinitely, you could say, okay? You can find the midpoint, the middle point of a line segment, because it's a certain length, whereas a line just goes on forever and ever and ever, so as such, doesn't have a middle, as it were. So this was just a little distinction between line segment and line. A line segment are the things we're going to be talking about in this particular video. So let's start by linking to what we've already known. I would like you to pause the video and could you plot the point 10 and 50 for me on this axis. 10 means 1 across, nothing up, so there. And 50 means 5 across, nothing up, there. Okay? Now what if I asked you to work out the midpoint of that line segment? And by what line segment do I mean? Well, I mean the line segment 1 to 5. What's the middle there? Well, it's pretty obvious that that coordinate there, 3 across, 0 up, is the middle. And that's the middle between 10 and 50. Why? Well, because to get from 1 to 3 is 2 spaces, and to get from 3 to 5 is 2 spaces. We didn't have to go up at all. So in this case, the midpoint between these two is 30. Let's have a go at another one. Plot these two coordinates for me, and could you work out the midpoint as well? 0, negative 2 is here. 0, 4 is here. If we want the midpoint, now what's the middle there? Well, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 long, so the middle is going to happen 1, 2, 3 here. The midpoint is going to be 0 across 1 up, and that's the midpoint of 0, 4 and 0, negative 2. Now what if someone asked you to draw those coordinates and find the midpoint? Let's have a go. 1, negative 2, so 1 across, 2 down, and 5 across, 4 up. How could you find the midpoint of that line segment there? Well, what you could do is you could hopefully realize that you could think of that line there as a line that's going across, followed by a line that's going up from this point here, so here. And what we could say is, well, how far do you have to go across? You go 1, 2, 3, 4 across. So halfway is going to be 1, 2 across here. How far do you have to go up? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So how far do you have to go up for halfway? 1, 2, 3 here. So as that line there meets that line there, this point here would be the middle. And that is the coordinates 3 across, 1 up. So it turns out the midpoint of this is 3, 1. Now, can you think of a way to get those numbers really quickly? Well, I certainly can. How do you get 3 from 5 and 1? Well, what you could do is you could add the numbers and divide by 2. 5 add 1 is 6. 6 divided by 2 gives me 3. Does it work here? Well, negative 2 add 4 is going to be positive 2 divided by 2 will give me 1. So what you can do to work out these numbers super quickly is you can take the average of the x numbers, you add the two x numbers and divide by 2, and you can take the average of the y numbers, you can add the two y numbers and divide by 2, and that will get you really quickly, without necessarily having to draw a picture, the midpoint of that line segment. So I just wanted to state that for you here. In general, the midpoint of a line segment between two pairs of coordinates, if you have a coordinate x1, y1, like here, and x2, y2, like here, if you want to find the midpoint, which is here, without having to draw it, what you can do is you can add the x's and divide by 2 to get the x-coordinate of the midpoint. You can add the y's and divide by 2 to get the y-coordinate of the midpoint. right? So let me give you an example. If someone said, what's the midpoint? And I'll make up some hard numbers. Let's say, what's the midpoint between 2, negative 8, and, I don't know, let's say 6, negative 2. What's the midpoint between them? Well, what you would do to get the x midpoint, you would add 2 and 6 and divide by 2 to get the average. So, and that would give you 8 divided by 2, which is 4. To get the y number for the midpoint, you would take negative 8 and you would add negative 2 and divide by 2, which will give you negative 5. So the midpoint, well, the x coordinate of it is going to be this 4. The y coordinate is negative 5. And that's how you do these midpoint questions. And now we're ready to go and try some. At each stage, pause the video and try it yourself. Find the midpoint of the line segments with end coordinates of 2, 1 and 6, 5. Okay, so to get the x coordinate, I'm just going to do 2 add 6 divided by 2. To get the y coordinate, I'm going to do 1 add 5 divided by 2. And I'm going to get 8 divided by 2, which is 4. And I'm going to get 6 divided by 2, which is 3. 4, 3 is the answer. What about these ones? Same thing here. You would add the x numbers, so 2 add 5 divided by 2. And you would add the y coordinates and half it, 1 add 4 divided by 2. This time we're going to get decimals, I think, because 2 add 5 is 7. 7 divided by 2, well, that's 3.5. We should write it as a decimal for coordinates here. 1 add 4 is 5. 5 divided by 2 is 2.5. Okay? Now, is it actually right? Let's just have a check by drawing one of them, 2, 1 and 6, 5. 2, 1 and 6, 5 there. If I drew a line between them, I'm saying that the middle is 4, 3, 4, 3. Yeah, it's pretty clear that the middle there, 4, 3, is true. What if I did 2, 1 and 5, 4? So again, 2, 1, but this time we're going to do 5 and 4 would be there. And the middle, I'm saying, is 3.5, 2.5, 3.5, 2. Yeah, that does look like the middle. Okay, so it does work in these cases, and you can always draw it if you're not so sure. Okay, keep going and pause the video and try these ones. Right, find the midpoint here. To find the x-coordinate of the midpoint, we're going to take negative 2, and I'm going to add 6 and half it. And to get the y-coordinate, I'm going to do y add negative 5 and half it. Negative 2 add 6 is 4. 4 divided by 2 is 2. 1 add negative 5 is like 1. Take away 5, which is negative 4. Negative 4 divided by 2 is negative 2. There we go. Done. What about here? Same thing. Take negative 2 and add negative 5 and divide the answer by 2. And here, take negative 1 and add negative 4 and divide by 2. Negative 2 add negative 5 is negative 7. Negative 7 divided by 2 is negative 3.5. Negative 1 add negative 4 is negative 5. Divided by 2 is negative 2.5. You could check by drawing as well. There's no need to, really. They're definitely right. Next one, pause and have a go. Same old stuff here. To get the midpoint, the x-coordinate of the midpoint, you would do negative 2 add 6 divided by 2. And here you would do 1 add 5 divided by 2. Negative 2 add 6 is going to be 4. 4 divided by 2 is 2. 1 add 5 is 6. 6 divided by 2 is 3. This one, negative 2 add 5 over 2. This one, negative 1 add 4 over 2. This one here is going to be 3 over 2, which is 1.5. This one here is going to be 3 over 2 again, which again would be 1.5. Why don't we just check with this one that that actually seems right? Negative 2, negative 1 is here. 5, 4 is here. Let's draw a line between them and see, does the midpoint look right? I'm saying the midpoint is 1.5, 1.5. Yeah, that definitely looks like the midpoint, and it seems like we've done it right. Well, here we're given negative 1, negative 2 is the midpoint, and we're given the coordinates of one of the ends of the line, S, is negative 4, 2. And we're asked to find the other end of the line segment, I should say, T. The best way to do this is to draw a picture. It will help, a little sketch. It doesn't have to be super accurate. Now, let's plot that for first. Negative 4, 2 means 4 back and 2 up. There's S. Negative 1, negative 2 means 1 back and 2 down here. And that I'm going to call the midpoint M. The question is, where is T? Well, because M is in the middle of S and T, T must be here. somewhere down here like that, right? We know S has the coordinates negative 4 and 2. We know M has the coordinates negative 1 and negative 2. How could we find T? Well, to get from S to M, we've gone from negative 4 to negative 1. We have moved in the x direction 3. So if we move another 3 in the x direction from negative 1, we'll get to 2 for the x direction there. And we've gone from positive 2 in the y's down to negative 2 down here for m. So we must have gone 4 down. So let's go another 4 down from negative 2, and we'll get to negative 6. So t must have the coordinates 2 and negative 6, and we're done. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.